I was married, very, very young the first time, and
his name was Ted.
Well, still is.
Ted.
Walk in the room, and very strong style cowboy type, walk in and go, hey, y'all.
My name's Ted.
That's how he introduced himself, and he wouldn't say another word for several hours after that. So anyway, because he was the strong silent type, he didn't like to discuss feelings or talk a whole lot with a woman, which is fine, very quiet guy, and I kind of mistook that for his disinterest in me. And I was, so it was a breakdown in communication there in some ways. So what I would do is I'd take the phone off the wall in the kitchen and stretch the cord, remember those? Anyway, I stretch the cord all the way through the house, all the way to the common room, and I lock myself in there to call my friends. For counsel.
About
you. Anyway, I had a married friend at the time that I would call, or she would wind me up even more. She was married too, and had her own problems. So misery loves company, and bitches be crazy. Encouraged me to stand up and, you know. Anyway, I had a single friend who I would also call after that phone call, and she had a bit of a different take on the advice. And she was always the bridesmaid, never the bride. She said, I'm here to tell you, girlfriend, the grass is not greener on this side of the fence. She said, you've got a guy here who loves you, and, you know, you need to try and work this out. It's slim pickings out here, I'm telling you.
I dated him in high school. Not her. You dated Skip Towns, you have no room to talk. I did, until one day he just didn't go in there anymore. It's like, so now I never came back in the number city because I never came back.
They dated Skip Towns and Slim Pickens and
there was
a ticket. Anyway, my single friend was trying to encourage me to work on it. Anyway, after I came out of the bathroom after 3 hours of jail, I was still in the same position he was in when I went into the bathroom with the remote and couch. I thought to myself, what am I going to do? Am I going to, you know, figure this out? I was looking for some inspiration and it hit me. The bolt of lightning from the sky. You need to write a country song! So I sat down at the kitchen table, and 9 minutes later I had this song. And after being turned down by every label in Nashville twice, 1994 rolled around and I got an audition with Mercury Records. And this time I sang this song, so I had something a little bit different. They called the next day and offered me a bona fide record deal. Songs and not have to sing Angela's and Susie Boggs songs all the time. Full circle. Anyway, so like, I think this song definitely helped me get my record deal and also helped me pay for the divorce.
Thank you.